What is up, everybody? This is that guy Tony, and I'm not going to be talking about very much in this episode, and it's mainly because I can't move my mouth, because I got my wisdom teeth extracted today as the time of recording this video, so not really going to be talking, but basically just got to design this room, which is going to be, I think I'm going to make an office just because it's sort of a small space instead of an apartment. I mean, I want the apartments to be a big size, like actual realistic size for an apartment, and this is just not a very realistic size for any type of apartment, unless it were a really cheap one, but this is in a skyscraper, so it'll probably be more expensive, and it's in the city, which means it'll be more expensive. I mean, I don't know. I just want to be putting these super dinky little apartments in my, city. Because it's supposed to be a very luxurious city, so it makes this an office part. So basically what we're going to be doing here is adding in some of this, which is going to be doing actually the elevator. We'll have that there, and then we'll do something like this, and this, and then have something like this, and this is gonna go all the way up the building. But yeah, so that's gonna work. Be kind of the elevator, so let's put that back there. And we'll also need to just drill a hole. Make sure no one can see anything via the inside of the elevator. I can't really talk because it kind of hurts a little to talk, not a lot. I mean, not in like a huge amount of pain, but I can hardly move my mouth when I talk because it hurts. That's why I'm like, you know, kind of like that. So, I apologize for that. But, hopefully you guys don't mind because it's not much worse than what I talk like when I before I had this wisdom tooth extraction. So. I think I wanna let's do it like this. That might look kinda good. Yeah, that's good. Alright, now I just need to add in the emergency stairs as well, so we'll make this, make it all white. And I guess what we'll do is just make them one wide. So I think we just need to do it like this. And then basically, we'll use some sandstone, but there'll be another door here. So what we'll do is do something like that. That. And then we're not going to be able to world edit once we clone this. We're not going to be able to get that bottom area, so on the second floor we'll have to modify it a little. Maybe modify both floors at the same time, just so it gets that extra stair in. Okay. So that is gonna work. And this other floor is gonna go right on top here. Okay, we'll do something like that. And something like that. And then we can do, this isn't supposed to be necessarily particularly comfortable. We'll do something like that. just kind of fill us all in. We have to fill us in by hand because we can only actually do the slash fill command on standard oak planks. It's really nice if they could update the slash fill command and add in the ability to fill all the different types of blocks that are now in 1.9 Minecraft. But you can't, like, things, you can only weld at it, like, standard oak planks, and you can't weld at any other type of planks, which is kind of disappointing. But, I guess it's just the way we had to do it. Maybe it's just because the other blocks are pretty complex, and they don't want, I don't know, people, you know, world editing a bunch and then blaming them that there's lag and things in the game, even though when they're world editing a lot, it may be kind of complicated. Because not everybody has a super fast computer. Including myself, I don't really have that fast of a computer. My consistent FPS for Minecraft is 60, which is not really that great. This computer wasn't entirely designed for gaming. So it's, you know, not particularly fast. It is a custom, it's built by my brother, but it wasn't really, you know, built for just gaming, which would be nice, but I was watching TechSource, which is a great YouTube channel. I absolutely love it. I love all that kind of tech stuff. I'm gonna try and be some sort of computer engineer or something, but you know, he has a $350 gaming PC. That's a custom build. He kind of does these monthly PCs, custom built PCs, and he tells you everything that you need and stuff. And he has a $350 gaming PC. So I'm totally losing track. I'm trying to I'm playing Clash of Clans at the same time. I'm sorry. Anyways, he has that, which is, I mean, it's pretty cool. And it's only $350, and I think it's, he said it plays like 40 or 50 FPS on GTA 5, which is pretty cool. Probably plays like 70 or 80 on Minecraft, but it's basically solely designed for gaming. Okay, so here we are with this floor, and now I gotta mess around with lighting and things. So what I'm gonna do, actually, is use a technique that I saw Daniel Lags using, and that is making a fan. So what we're gonna do here is grab some spruce fence, some brown carpet. You can also do this any kind of color carpet you want, but I'm just using this for now, and then we're gonna need some string. So string is placeable with the introduction of tripwires and things, so let me just first set time to 0 here. And if this will send a stupid challenge, send the challenge on Clash Clans. Anyways, so basically what I'm gonna do is take this thing, we're gonna put a in here. Now, I don't know if I can actually do this or not, but I don't know, looks like we can. Okay, so basically you just place the string on the bottom of the block. I'm not really sure how he did this, so I think he just did it like that. And then place some more string on that other string block there. And then we place the carpet on top of that. This not only gives us some light, but it kind of disguises the lamp and makes it into a fan, which is pretty cool. Okay, so there that is. And then I think we'll just kind of put another lamp right here. And another lamp right here. And then what we'll do is we'll kind of, I think what I'm gonna do here is separate this area with some glass, So this will kind of be the main office space here. So I'll put a nice little wall there. And we'll put that right along there. I don't know if I like how this is going to turn out, but I'm nice looking at getting GTA 5, not to actually play the game, but actually just to get LSPDFR on it, which is basically allows you to become a law police officer kind of thing, which is really cool. And I've been watching, I've always kind of liked that cop stuff, and all the police and sirens and the trucks, I've always been that kind of kid. And I've been watching guys like first 30 minutes and Jeff Fabiano play that game. I mean, I've been watching first 30 minutes for over a year, or, you know, ever since the GTA 5 LSPDFR mod came out, I've been watching them play it. And so I was just watching a video today, and I was like, man, I should really get that. But it doesn't look like my computer wants to be compatible with, GTA 5, which is the main base game. You're just putting a modification on to it, which is LSPDFR. So my computer doesn't want a CPU, and I think it's mainly my CPU and my graphics card. I have enough RAM, all that stuff, but my computer just does not want to work, which is unfortunate. But I don't know. I was asking around on the forums, my computer could run it. I'm a little bit skeptical because I could actually run Battlefield 4. It went pretty well on my computer. There wasn't really any problem with it. And it's like, no, you can't run GTA 5. I'm like, what? What? So I'm a little bit skeptical on whether people actually telling the truth. I tried it on canyourunit.com, I think is what it was called. But it was just, I don't know, really weird. I was like, wait, so I can run Battlefield 4, but not, okay. You know, it's just kind of like, what? I don't get ya. No, it's really kind of weird. But I don't know. Still kind of waiting for some more replies on the forum, because I accidentally forgot to not write down what my graphics card was, but a lot of people are still saying that I can do. My computer is even struggling to get the minimum, or is less than the minimum required to run LSPDFR, so unfortunate, but we'll see what happens. Okay, anyways, we're decorating this room. This is just going to be kind of like a little waiting room for the, all the offices. Probably have like a nice little coffee bench here or something. I guess we can get like a brewing stand. I'll just get like a little trash can here. Stand, and I guess we'll put like simulate a cabinet. We can put a little trap door there or something like that, and then actually use some granite here because that looks pretty nice. And then I guess I'll put some pots and things, maybe a little plant and things. Nice little pot. And then I guess we can kind of I'll do another table here. Let's do a stair table. Like so. put a nice little pot there. And I guess let's just get some poppy or something to put in here. I'm being totally blind right now. I'm really out of it, as I said before, because like amnesia or whatever they use to put you to sleep and everything, and my mouth is kinda hurt, so I don't know why I'm talking so much. I need to like chill, but alright, so looks I just challenged some people. New update in Clash Clans allows you to challenge your clanmates to try to defeat your village. Anyways, I think this looks pretty good. Thinking though, maybe we should kinda put a table here or something. So, I think that's what we'll do. I don't know. Okay, table right there, and I want to move that gray wall back. Man, he attacked me with giants. I don't actually have an attack strat going right now, so he wants me to, he wants to know if I can beat his village. He's a tall 10, but he has like 3 expos, but he has like level 5 walls and stuff. He's kind of premature. Town Hall, I guess we'll use, let's use brown carpet here. We can actually just place this on top of the other carpet. Let's actually just do that. There we go, alright. Good enough, right? And I think that is gonna do it. Technically, 10 giants. 53%. It's a little bit too close for comfort to me, but I'm a ton only. He has like tier 5 troops and stuff. Okay, so here, I want to make sure the swords are good because I'm going to be copying the same exact floor through the rest of the skyscraper tower thing, so. Yeah, alright. So, in this thing, be using some white shares. And we'll have 3 chairs here, I think. And we'll basically just kind of, this will kind of be the area office part of the building. It'll just be kind of the office guy's desk here. Which, once again, watching Dan Lags, I got down some techniques that I think I can use. We're gonna be using, let's use a jungle door, and then we're gonna need a jungle slab. Jungle slab, there you are. Okay. So now, basically, I want this desk to go all the way over here. And now, basically, I'll have the chair go like this. And so kind of actually make it look like the chair is being or has been scooted underneath the desk. So let's see here. Do it like this and put down the string. Okay. I can just kind of put that down all along here. Since I'm not going to be putting in any custom NPCs or anything, it's not really necessary to make it look like it's actually alive inside. And I'll put that chair right there. And then put some wood on the ends. I guess since we're using the kind of brown and spruce fence and everything, we'll kinda do it like that. And okay, we'll put some flower pots here. And then we'll get some, like a different color flower here. Let's do pink. Okay. And then we're gonna need some sort of computer here, so kinda looking and thinking what I can use. So this is not gonna let me. I can do it like that though. And then I can put an item frame on here. What I can actually do is, or what I'm going to do is get a map. So we'll search map here, and then we'll let the map fill in. And then I can actually do is to make it seem more like a computer. Can actually kind of put that on. But that still doesn't look right, does it? So let's get a piece of coal, I guess. So put that right there still. And can I actually still put a carpet here or not? Let's put a gray thing there. If we can actually put the carpet there without the item frame falling off, that would be awesome. And then this is gonna be an Apple computer, so oops. Clash Clans going, okay. This is Apple. We're gonna clear the weather here. Oh my gosh. Slash time says room. Okay, so here's kind of the main desk area. I'm gonna quickly, you'll just see black here real quick. We've been recording for about 22 minutes, so I'd love to finish up this desk before ending this episode. So let's do that. Okay, and I want to get some chests back there, maybe like an anvil. And we'll also get, you know, some leaves so we can actually kind of use those as kind of bush decorations. Almost kind of forgot about those. We're in the weird biome though, so what if I were to use jungle? Would that make it actually be green? No, it wouldn't. That was so nasty. Okay. And we need some chests back here. And then we'll just kind of do something like this. That. And we'll do something like that. And we'll get a trap door here. Hopefully, this actually clones everything that I have here. Because I don't know, it might just clone blocks. And then we'll kind of put a little trap door entrance thing there. I love the sounds of these new blocks. Okay, and I think that's pretty much gonna do it for the office here. Let's put another table actually on. We'll do something like this. And then we get some more flowers. And we get some sort of little bush here, I think. Maybe a sapling. Let's get a little sapling. Because they're cute. Okay, and there we go. So that is basically gonna do it for this episode, guys. We basically got this area now completed. Or this floor anyways, and now next episode I'll do a time lapse or a speed up video. I don't know why I keep calling them time lapse, because technically they're not time lapses. But we'll do a speed up video of me just cloning this, because it's pretty boring to watch, as I've explained before. Just watching someone do the same thing over and over again, like typing the same command over and over again, is not very exciting to watch. So we will speed that up, but yeah, there's kind of the interior of the office from the outside. It looks pretty good. And we'll have a bunch of these. We have the fire escape or slash stairs there. And we got the elevator on this side. This will kind of be the front view. Now that kind of elevator will go all the way up. And then I also want to copy this. And actually just use this and go all the way around. If it was an apartment building, actually before I was planning to do an apartment building, I was planning on putting a balcony in. But that's not really necessary for an apartment building, but maybe we will do it anyways. This isn't like a typical office, this is probably like an attorney's office, or you know, well in this case several attorney's offices, where they can you know, set up office and all that stuff. Although all the floors are identical, you know, they have each floor labeled which doctor or attorney who's there and there. If it was like an office or like some sort of a headquarters or something, I would have it kind of split into like cubicles for each worker to work at, but this is not that kind of office. So put a little lip around the top there. I think that makes it a little bit better, and I think we'll put a little bit more texture into it, make it not look as flat once we keep copying it over and over again. So that's gonna do it for this episode, guys. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys all next time. See you later.